from Jackson Hole, Wyoming, welcome to Live from the Grand Teton Music Festival. Each summer, led by Maestro Sir Donald Runnicles, more than 200 of the world's finest orchestral players gather to make music. The international audience is unique. They may hike, bike, or sightsee during the day, but they also come to Jackson for the evenings for some of the finest music making anywhere, the Grand Teton Music Festival. I'm Emma Kale, Executive Director of the festival, and I'd like to introduce you to our hosts, Jeff Counts and Sir Donald Runnicles.
Jeff, folk music, Volksmusik, or the music of the people, has had a very strong influence on composers of all kinds of music, from Ludwig van Beethoven to Gustav Mahler to Ralph Vaughan Williams. Perhaps two composers, however, who've been the most influenced by folk music are both from or near the Balkan Peninsula. George Enescu and Bela Bartók. Why do you think this is?
For me, the most interesting aspect to this folk music influence is that both of these gentlemen were born into a century during which nationalism in music was very much on the rise in some of the cultures throughout Europe. Particularly, I'm talking about Eastern Europe and Northern Europe, because I think that for a lot of these cultures, nationalism meant not German and, to a certain degree, not French. I think that was true in Romania, true in Hungary, and trying to establish a national voice was something that often fell to a single person. For these two gentlemen, they were, in many ways, the voice of their nation. Enescu and Bartók were both exiled late in their lives. In their early music, their early reliance on folk influence, I can't help but see some of the coloration of that later heartbreak in that music. Do you find some of that too?
Yes, and it's in some ways completely paradoxical that they are pining, if you like, or they're nostalgic for a world where these countries were subsumed. And now these countries had emerged. But ironically, with this emergence, there was then that new danger of, once again, larger influences taking over these countries. And as you say, they were then both in exile and nostalgic for something that perhaps had never really existed.
Let's listen now as Maestro Cristian Măcelaru takes the stage to rapturous applause at Walk Festival Hall. He will conduct the festival orchestra here at the Grand Teton Music Festival in George Enescu's Romanian Rhapsody No. 1. You've just heard Maestro Cristian Măcelaru leading the Grand Teton Music Festival Orchestra in Jackson Hole, Wyoming, in a performance of George Enescu's Romanian Rhapsody, No. 1.
You're listening to Live from the Grand Teton Music Festival.
I'm Jeff Counts.
And I'm Donald Runnicles. We turn now to one of the great masterpieces of the 20th century, the Concerto for Orchestra by the Hungarian composer Béla Bartók. The story is well known. Bartók moved to the United States in 1940, fleeing the Nazi oppression. He was already sick with leukemia and had virtually no energy to compose. In 1943, the conductor of the Boston Symphony Orchestra, Serge Koussevitzky, visited Bartók in a hospital and offered him a commission of $1,000, pretty generous at the time. Bartók declined, but Koussevitzky left $500 with Bartók. Bartók's leukemia went into remission, and he composed the Concerto for Orchestra, the largest work he had composed in 25 years. Béla Bartók said to a friend, "What nobody could possibly see in the score is that through working on the concerto, I have discovered the wonder drug I needed to bring about my own cure." Jeff, it's a wonderful, wonderful anecdote.
I'm thinking about Koussevitzky and his influence at the time. In 1 year alone, he commissioned Prokofiev for the Hindemith Concert Music for Brass and Strings, Stravinsky's Symphony of Psalms. He commissioned the Ravel Pictures arrangement. I mean, what an incredible voice for contemporary music he was, and still is, even after his life. There's a great story with the Concerto for Orchestra. There's a part that quotes the "Meet me at Maxime's" moment from The Merry Widow of Franz Lehár. And it's important to note that he was not actually quoting Lehár. He was quoting Shostakovich, who had made an exhaustive use of that descending theme in his Seventh Symphony, the Leningrad Symphony, and he used that music to depict the coming German army before the siege. I knew Peter Bartók very well when I was living in Florida. I remember him telling me about his father listening to that piece and counting the repetitions of that theme, the ad nauseum repetitions of that theme, and becoming more and more frustrated and angry as he got into the higher numbers. So I love the story of this very tongue-in-cheek parody of Shostakovich, which itself was somewhat of a parody of Franz Lehár.
Maestro Vasily Petrenko takes the podium to lead, in fact, to show off the brilliant festival orchestra in the Concerto for Orchestra by Béla Bartók, here in the Walk Festival Hall at the Grand Teton Music Festival in Jackson Hole. You've just heard a performance of the Concerto for Orchestra by Béla Bartók. The conductor was Vasily Petrenko. He took the podium. The orchestra of the Grand Teton Music Festival.
This has been a presentation of the Grand Teton Music Festival, located in Jackson Hole, Wyoming.
Live from the Grand Teton Music Festival is a co-production of the Grand Teton Music Festival and Classic Digital Syndications. Victor Munzer is our producer. He is also a recording engineer, as is Kevin Harbison.
We would love to hear from you, so please write to us. Simply send us an email to listener@gtmf.org. And by all means, please visit us this summer in Jackson Hole. For more information about the festival, go to gtmf.org. I'm Jeff Counts.
And I'm Donald Runnicles. Thank you for being with us.